Thomas carry. Finds a little running room out to the 43-yard line. Picked up 3 yards on the play before Bob Bell brought him down. So it'll be second and seven.
Talk about the Cardinals putting those two National Football League championships back-to-back, but they've come up dry in the playoffs. They were beaten at Los Angeles last year, 35-23 in the playoffs. And when they won in 1974, they lost at Minnesota by a score of 30-14.
They were born the Chicago Cardinals. It's second and seven now at the 43-yard line. Riggins, the fullback, here is the handoff to Tommy. He tries off tackle left. Loses his balance, but gets on up to the 50-yard line. Penalty markers are thrown. Penalty markers, and he skidded along, and he was stopped at the 50-yard line. But the flags were thrown all over.
I believe it was Bob Bell, came in with a late hit, almost a spear hit Thomas in the back as he was lying on the ground. He had already been tackled, and Bell came around, gave it one more shot, and that's going to help the Redskins considerably. When you consider the condition of this field, 15 yards is like 15 acres,
or maybe 15 minutes, the way it's been going, and so the penalty will be marked up. I guess the St. Louis Cardinals, Bernie Ullman, the referee, is placing it down at the 35-yard line. First and 10 Redskins at the Cardinal 35. Keep in mind that the St. Louis Cardinals have a 4-point lead.
That's the first down and a half the Redskins don't have to worry about.
Exactly what it is, as Ullman indicates the personal foul. And the Washington Redskins reconvene their huddle. They were brought to Washington from Boston by the late George Preston Marshall, one of the flamboyant football showmen. The Redskins were the first franchise ever to stage flamboyant halftime shows. First and 10 at the 35-yard line. Riggins is the fullback, but Thomas gets the football off tackle right, and he moves to the 31-yard line. In a 4 yards, it'll be second and six. Bob Bell across to make the tackle for the St. Louis Cardinals as Larry Brown comes out of the field once again for Washington.
Mike Thomas has just been superb tonight. He's been able to keep his footing. 16 carries, a total of 74 yards on his way to a 100-yard game. As you mentioned, Larry Brown is in there. Larry Brown, a fine pass receiver in the event that Gilmer wants to go to the air.
Second down play coming now. As they send Roy Jefferson to the left side, they bring Frank Grant to the right side. Split out the running back. Larry Brown left and Mike Thomas right. Billy Gilmer quarterbacking. And this is Larry Brown. Jitterbugs his way up to about the 29-yard line. Way up there at the 29.
I want to backtrack on a comment I made before. It was not Bob Bell who got called for the penalty. It was Charlie Davis, the 6'2", 265-pound, three-year man from TCU, because I recognized the 76, and he just made the stop, and Charlie Davis getting a little physical.
I should say, third down and four now. Third and four for the Redskins. That's the crowd now. Edges forward. And this third down circumstance, we have 12 minutes and 30 seconds left to play in the game. Here's Gilmer back to throw to try to pick it up. He can't find anybody open. He's sacked. Gilmer is sacked around the ankles. It was Mike Dawson. Mike Dawson had him around the ankles and dropped him. So it is fourth down, and he's dropped way back at the 36-yard line.
And that should be about the, seventh sack, eighth sack against the Redskins. That's going to give them 23 for the year, right? They were sacked seven times in the first half. They've now been sacked 23 times. And we saw quite a performance when we were on the West Coast as the 49ers sacked Jimmy Harris a total of 10 times.
Mike Bragg, the punter, has come onto the field. The big difference in the ballgame has been the ability of the St. Louis Cardinal defensive line to control the line of scrimmage. The Washington Redskins offensive line has been powerless to do anything about it. Situation here with Bragg standing on the 50. Nobody back deep. They're going to let him kick it. He does put it toward the coffin corner to the right side and gets it out of bounds at the 6-yard line. The 6-yard line, it'll be first and 10. A 31-yard punt, but a coffin corner boot and with the score. St. Louis 10, Washington 6. There's a timeout on the field. Now this for Buick Automobile.
Buy a Buick Opel anytime and you get a sensational little car. One that's comfortable, fun to drive, built by Isuzu, and equipped with things like a four-cylinder overhead cab hemi engine, a short-throw four-speed manual transmission, plus reclining bucket seats, tinted glass, and rack and pinion steering. But for those of you who buy one between now and October 31st, there's a special offer that goes with it. 200 gallons of gas in a new Opel, you could do a lot of driving. Of course, your mileage may vary, but the estimated EPA city mileage alone of 23 miles per gallon, that's 4,600 miles. And on the highway, Opel's EPA estimate is 36 miles per gallon. Not bad, The Buick Opel Gas Offer. See your Buick Opel dealer soon for details and make your best deal. You'll get a great little car that gives you what you pay for. And 200 gallons of gas from Buick. In California, EPA estimates are lower.
Well, it's the fourth quarter, 12:17 left to play in the game. 10-6 St. Louis out in front. Cardinals, 11 possessions, Washington, 12. Three in the second half for St. Louis, two for Washington. And now the Redskins defense has to come up with a big play. The Redskins defense, of course, will try to force a mistake on the part of the Cardinals. And on a night like this, it can be done. They're at the six-yard line. The Cards are first and 10 in their own territory. Jim Hart calling starting signals and waiting for the snap. He's running back three, evened up wide receivers left and right. Tries to pivot the arm, the handoff. Otis Garrett, the fullback, and he got about a yard out to the 7-yard line, so call it second and nine at the seven. Darren Talbot, Dennis Johnson, McClint, the center of the Redskin line, pile him up. Kilmer obviously doesn't have the mobility of a Joe Theismann, and it's on that play, and I can't understand why the Redskins do not employ the same tactic that the Dallas Cowboys do with Roger Staubach, and that's go to the shotgun. I understand what you mean. It's second and nine now at the 7-yard line. St. Louis Cardinals are in possession. That's Metcalf and Otis in the setback position. Now they start Mel Gray in motion from a set left all the way across to the right side. Again, it is given to Otis. He's looking for running room. He powers his way up to the 10-yard line.
toy chairs. They're on sale now.
the go, the American sports fan wants an insight into what's happening. And the Mutual Radio Network makes it just that easy for the fan to be in the know. Every Saturday and Sunday, Mutual presents Wide Weekend of Sports. Covering a wide variety of happenings, Wide Weekend is the most comprehensive and complete sports show on network radio. Anchored by veteran sportscaster Dale Conquest, Wide Weekend takes the inquisitive sports fan across the nation and sometimes the world, and that's no exaggeration. Wide Weekend keeps up with the major team sports, plus the individual ones like tennis, golf, and horse racing. 33 times each Saturday and Sunday, Dale Conquest calls on his wealth of knowledgeable correspondents for previews, updates, and wrap-ups direct from the scene. So for a total insight into the sports world, catch Mutual, Wide Weekend of Sports, over this Mutual station.
The kickoff now is in the air. Over to the right side, Latin has it at the 15, to the 20, to the 25, Jerry Latt to the 30, and he is stopped at the 34-yard line. The Cardinals will start first at 10, Dallas Hickman downfield to make the tackle. Lindsey, the punt return, 71 yards for a touchdown by Eddie Brown. It's the first return by a Redskin this year. And I did not see all the stats yesterday, but going into this week's action, the longest punt return for a score was 67 yards by Pete Hazen. New Orleans against Houston on October 3rd, so that might be a high for this season.
First and 10 for the Cardinals now. They're 10 points down with 8 minutes, 56 seconds left to play in the game. Jim Hart brings them up. Wide receivers double to the left side. The running backs are split for Hart. Redskins adjust their defensive, dropping back now as Hart takes a look, goes long to the right side, short. Did not get it out to J.B. Kane, who dropped to his knees. The ball hit a full yard in front of him. Flashing water around, although the rain has almost stopped. It's still misting rain here in Washington. Second and 10 at the 34.
Well, there's a lot of timing, but it's in 51 seconds left to play, but the playing conditions are abominable. And as great a passer as Jim Hart is, and of course the kind of protection he gets from his offensive line, it's going to take some doing. But the Cardinals are going to have to come up with a big play. The one thing that George Allen worries about, Cardinals a big play team.
They are a big play team, but it's a tough night under these conditions to play catch-up football. They're 10 points down. It's second and 10 at the 34. Hart drops back again, takes a look, goes up the middle, and it's intercepted at the 46.
By the Redskins, and they lead the National Football Conference in that category.
So the Redskins, leading by 10 points, have the ball in Cardinal territory. A Redskin victory here tonight would put them even with the St. Louis Cardinals, one game back of the Dallas Cowboys, who won yesterday to go to 6-1. 9 St. Louis turnovers in this ball game here tonight. They're up there, first and 10 out of the 39-yard line. Kilmer slanting out, hands the ball off to Thomas, and Thomas can go nowhere. Big pull down. Tempers flaring once again on the field, and Bob Bell made the tackle. It's going to be marked at the 41-yard line. Loss of 2 on the play. It'll be second down and 12 yards to go.
Redskin coach George Allen talking to the linesman, saying, hey, a little too physical after all. My man was down, and George not getting anywhere. Loss on the play of 4. It'll be second down and 14. We've got 8 minutes coming up. 8:05 showing on the clock as the Redskins come out of the huddle with a 10-point lead.
Grant and Jefferson, a double to the left side. Riggins is ahead of Thomas in the I formation. Now here is the pitch to Thomas. He is hitting off back to the right, but can never get there as he is pulled down. Back at the 44-yard line for a loss of 2 more. Larry Stallings brought him down.
Well, that Cardinal defensive line being able to move out very quickly to the laterally to the sideline. And right now they have stopped the running game, and Larry Brown's coming in. And John Riggins will come out. So with third down, we'll be able to see Billy Kilmer put that ball in the air.
Coming off the field now is John Riggins, and Larry Brown has come in for the Washington Redskins. Kilmer breaks the huddle now. Here come the Redskins with Grant coming out to the left side and Roy Jefferson to the right. Thomas is set left. Brown is set right. Here is Thomas. Gets to the 20-yard line, and he is pulled out at the 37. A penalty mark. run it upfield. That's going to put the ball inside the 25, down to about the 23-yard line. First and 10 for the Redskins, who are leading in this game by a score of 20-10 with 7 minutes, 3 seconds left to play. Robert F. Kennedy Stadium in Washington, D.C. Washington Redskins still mindful of the fact that it was the St. Louis Cardinals who knocked them out of any playoff possibility last year. The Cardinals went on into the playoffs and were defeated by the Los Angeles Rams in a game in which Lawrence McCutchen gained a record 202 yards, a game you might have heard broadcast on Mutual last December. Here is Kilmer now getting one off to Thomas on a counter. He gets inside the 20 to the 19-yard line. Bob Bell made the tackle after a gain of 4 by Thomas. It's going to be 2nd and 6 at the 19.
Well, the Redskins, of course, would like to slug it out yard by yard, inch by inch, with the second tick off the clock. It's now wound down to 6 minutes and 45 seconds. They're out in front here by a score of 20 to 10. And one more score would just about wrap it up. Thomas had 21 carries, a total of 87 yards.
Second out and 6 yards to go for the Redskins. At the Cardinals' 19-yard line, Grant to the left side, Roy Jefferson right. Thomas and Brown, and Thomas gets the ball, goes over his own left guard, and gets it to the 17-yard line. He picked up 2, it'll be 3rd and 4. Mark Arnesman made the tackle.
Mike Thomas, the workhorse tonight. And we kind of hope you're getting a kick out of tonight's game down in Atlanta, Georgia, as you listen over WSB, one of the nation's really great radio stations. And we're happy to be coming into Pleasanton, Idaho on KPST and in Galesburg, Illinois over KGIL.
The Washington Redskins are leading the St. Louis Cardinals 20-10 here in the fourth quarter. Wide receivers left and right, 3rd and 4. Running backs are evened up. Thomas left, Brown right, and angling out to the right side is Kilmer to put it up. He throws complete at the 15-yard line. And now tempers are flaring once again, and the officials are trying to keep the ball players apart.
I believe one of the players is Terry Hermeling, and it is. The other is linebacker Tim Kearney. Norm Thompson of the Cardinals breaks it up. And now the tempers start to flare.
Larry Brown took the pass out of bounds, the 15, and then he stretched his body out trying to get past the first down six. It'll depend entirely on where the ball is spotted. May very well have picked it up. It is 1st and 10. 1st and 10 for the Washington Redskins. On the pass to Larry Brown, the ball is taken to the inbound marker and spotted now outside the 12-yard line.
Lindsey, I do believe the rains have subsided.
I think you're right.
Just a very light miss.
That doesn't count.
All right, life miss doesn't count.
1st and 10 now for the Redskins. They're leading the Cardinals 20-10. It's still Brown and Thomas at the setback. Gilmer takes a look around, bends in now, gives it off to Thomas, comes right, tries to cut back, but he can't. It's just about at the line of scrimmage for no gain. It's 2nd and 10. Jen Reeves, a strong safety, made the stop at the 12-yard line.
On the Ersatz grass at St. Louis a week ago, the Cardinals completely shut off the Dallas Cowboys running game with Roger the Dodger Staubach. Had to go to the air, and for the most part in the second half, had to go to the shotgun. And of course, we understand he has a fractured finger, but Roger said that there's no way he's going to miss the game against the Redskins next Sunday here at RFK.
He won't want to miss it because that is some kind of rivalry. The Dallas Cowboys and the Washington Redskins, 2nd and 10 at the 12-yard line. It's Thomas on a quick opener. He gets to the 10-yard line. Up the middle, it's going to be 3rd down. And 8 yards to go for the Redskins at the 10-yard line of the St. Louis Cardinals.
If a young fellow by the name of Mike Collins, who is last year's Rookie of the Year, gets his 100 yards, he will have earned it tonight. And he's fairly close to it right about now. 91, he needs 9 more. We've got 4:02, 4 minutes showing on the clock now in the fourth quarter.
As they break the huddle, it's Jefferson and Grant double to the left side. Fugit has stood out there about 7 yards to the right side. Here's the pass, and it's incomplete. Billy Kilmer retreated, tried to pop it out to Larry Brown to the left side, but 4th down now, and coming out is Mark Mosley to try the field goal.
Well, the Redskins are out in front here, 20-10. Mark Mosley has a couple of field goals tonight. 2 coming in the first quarter, both from 33 yards out. That gave the Redskins a 6-0 lead. The Cardinals went out in front by a score of 7-6 at the half on a Jim Hart to J.B. Kane pass. right, spin that ball around. The snapback is also very important, and the timing by Mosley is important. It'll be about a 27-yard kick, Lindsey.
Theismann now down on one knee, hand outstretched, waits for the snap, puts it down, and Mosley boots it up, and it's blocked. It is blocked. It is scrambled for it, goes over to the St. Louis Cardinals. And again, the tempers are flaring, and the officials are trying to keep the ball players separated. Units changing, and the ball players coming out of the field slow down. The Cardinals get the football. They'll have it first and 10 at their own 14-yard line.
That's the second time tonight that Mosley has had a field goal block. He's made two, had two blocks.
Clock shows 3 minutes, 42 seconds remaining to be played as the Redskins held them off for some 4 minutes with a 10-point lead here in Washington, D.C.
You know, another great contest is underway in the United States as we get ready to pick a new president. At Mutual News, they've pulled out all the stops to bring you the fastest, most accurate election results possible. So make plans now to vote for the candidate of your choice election day. Then follow the return to election night right here on Mutual, the world's largest radio news network. Next Sunday afternoon, these Mutual microphones. It's going to be the Dallas Cowboys and the Washington Redskins. And if you think the emotion ran high here tonight, wait till next Sunday if the Redskins win this one and they're out in front 20-10. Next Monday night, Lindsey and I are going to be in Baltimore, Maryland, where the Baltimore Colts take on the Houston Oilers at Memorial Stadium. And then Don Crickey and Pat Sheridan will be along on Saturday afternoon, Cleveland, Ohio Municipal Stadium, for the game between Notre Dame and Navy. Looking at the stats, Hart, 11 out of 24, 128 yards, one touchdown pass, and a couple intercepted. And I'll tell you, trying to give that most valuable player award tonight to the outstanding player, offensively and defensively, is going to be a little bit sticky, Lindsey Nelson.
It's a little bit sticky, just like the play has been on the field here tonight, because of the fact that we had heavy rain all day yesterday in Washington, and heavy rain starting an hour before kickoff here tonight. It has just about subsided, but it's been played under slow conditions. It's been a slow track. Now the Cardinals trailing by 10, held the ball first and 10 of their own 14-yard line, and they have 3 minutes, 42 seconds to see what they can do about it. Jim Hart brings them up. Wide receivers to the left and right, and the running backs are split. Hart drops back to set up, gets all the way back to his own 5, up the middle, and it is completed. Taken by Ike Harris across the 35-yard line. First and 10 at the 36. Joe Lavender made the tackle as they went up the middle for the completion there to Ike Harris.
Have to like Ike Harris. 22-yard pass play from Hart to Harris. He's leading pass receiver. Everybody talks about Metcalf. Everybody talks about Gray, but Ike.
No further damage done. Seven-10 on the clock, second period. Rangers with a two-goal lead. Goals by Dylan Esposito and Hickey. LaRouche has scored an unassisted goal for the Penguins.
Face-off deep in Pittsburgh.
The Soviet.